Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to take a set of images like this and turn it into a 3D model that you can use in games or just renders in general. Just, you know, useful to have. To follow along with this tutorial, you're going to need a decent PC. It doesn't have to be amazing, but I would at least recommend 16 gigs of RAM, or you won't be able to actually generate the mesh, which we'll be doing at the end. And obviously, photogrammetry is a very time-consuming and resource-heavy process, so the better your PC, the quicker this process will be, essentially. In terms of software, for this video, we're going to be using Agisoft Metashape. They have a 30-day free trial, which you can use to follow this video. You're also going to need 3D software. I'm going to be using Maya. Blender is a free alternative, or ZBrush, if you have that. You'll obviously need a camera for this process. A DSLR is preferred. You can make all the images have the same lens settings, so you have identical photos. A lot of Android phones have a pro mode, which lets you do the same thing, which can also be used. Okay, so your first step is to find something that you want to scan and take pictures of it. Ideally, you want to take these pictures in strips, orbiting around the object. You want about a 40 to 20% overlap with these photos, because the software will match points together to try and calculate the location of the cameras. When taking these photos, you want to set your camera to manual mode so you can tweak the settings. Your ISO and shutter speed should be adjusted to get good looking images, but your f-stop should stay at a pretty low value, as we want the shallow depth of field to make the background blurred and the subject stand out. Also, if you're taking photos outside, you want to try and do them on an overcast day, as this will give you a nice even lighting for your pictures. Let's start in Agisoft by going to Workflow, Add Photos, then Workflow, Align Photos, and set the quality to low. Once the images are finished aligning, you'll get something that looks pretty good. The only problem is that it's matched way too many points, which will make our model lose a lot of detail when it comes to building the mesh and the texture. So to fix this, we're going to have to make some masks. We can create masks by double-clicking on an image, and using the intelligent scissors, we can start drawing around the object that we want to match, and then press Add Selection. Anything in this area we've selected will not be matched. For this set of images, I've selected one image out of each one of the bursts to create a mask. This will remove the background in almost every direction. Once you've finished making the masks, go back and realign the photos. Set accuracy to high, and under advanced, go apply mask to and set it to tie points. Press OK and wait. As you can see with this camera alignment, there is way less background, which means that we can keep the detail on the object we actually want. From here, we can go to Workflow, Build Dense Cloud. I'm going to set my quality to high and my depth filtering to aggressive. I tried one with a mild, but it caused a few problems, so you can mess around with it to see which works best for you. Once we've built the dense cloud, we can go to Workflow and Build Mesh. Set the face count to either high or medium or low, depending on what kind of model you want. Higher face counts here will take a significantly longer time than medium or lower ones, so pick one that works for you and one that your computer can handle. Once the mesh has been built, it's time to go to Workflow and Build Texture and just leave the options to default. Once you're ready to export your model from Agisoft, go to File, Export, and Export Model. Save it as an FBX because then this will save transformations, which will make it much easier to bring back into Agisoft. In our 3D software, we want to import the mesh that we've created and delete any faces that we do not want. This could be random bits floating around or the floor. It's also very important not to rotate, scale, or transform our object at all, as then we will not be able to bring it back into Agisoft. Once you've removed any faces you don't want, we want to decimate the mesh. Depending on the program you use, it will either call decimate, reduce, but essentially we just want to lower the poly count of our mesh. This mesh I've lowered by 70%, and I think that's a roundabout good number to do. Once you've decimated the mesh, it's time to export the model back into Agisoft. We want to export as FBX to keep the position of the mesh. In Metashape, we want to import this new mesh and build a texture over the top of it. Because we've removed these excess faces, the new texture will have a better resolution than the one before. Once this new texture is finished building, we can export the mesh as FBX and bring it into Maya again. Once we've imported this final mesh into Maya, we're going to reorient it so it's the right way up, and there you have it, your model is finished. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, leave them below and enjoy.